Welcome back, trainers. So we're going to be discussing gym leaders and Pokemon League in Pokemon Go. I've discussed this in the past when we had level 10 gyms, but I thought I should talk about it again, thanks to somebody who left a comment on Twitter, kind of bringing it back to me. So I thought I'd make a video about it, discussing it and sharing my thoughts on how I think it would work. And I think it's a pretty good one, because the last time I was discussing this was when they had the level 10 gyms. So we didn't have raids or anything like that. We have 8 gym leaders for the Kanto region, right? And then 4 members of the Elite Four, followed up by the champion. Now I have several ideas for this. It's gonna be pretty fun. Happy to share my ideas here, including even maybe a possible invite to the very end. Okay, so first off, you would go with Brock. Now, how would they appear? Just like raids do. They have everything set up. Even if they do a rework, I'm pretty sure the raids are going to stay, right? So they would still be able to interact with the gyms. They can just appear at random. Now, the first one, Brock, would be common. You know, fairly common. And then as it goes down Misty, and then farther in and farther in, the farther you get down into the gym badges, only people who've beaten the first one will be able to see the next one. So if you beat Brock, you go on to Misty, and so on. And then eventually, you'll be able to get into the Elite Four. Now let's take a step back here and talk about this. The first gym, Brock, how would you be able to do it? Just go in there, and you battle it. I think it's going to be equivalent to a level 3 raid. Altogether, you're going to have to use all your Pokemon. You're not going to be able to pick a, you know, your strongest legendary and just go in there. I also think legendaries should be unpermitted to use, so it actually is a challenge, okay? I think that would be fantastic, as a matter of fact. So you go in there, you beat the raid, you get your badge. There'd be a whole new section. We'd get badges, and it would be great, right? Doesn't that sound fun? Possibly even you have to fight their teammates before you actually fight the actual gym leader. Just like in the main series games. I mean, all this can be introduced. It really could. It would be so cool. Could you imagine going into there and it'd be kind of like a have some sort of special gym music, and then you beat their friends, and then you finally get to the gym leader, and it kind of looks like a raid. It'll have the gym leader with their main Pokemon standing next to them, or their whole team, and then you just go at it. You'd have to pick type-wise, and they would have similar teams to the main series. Now, this is what I think it would look like. Now, keep in mind, I didn't really do anything special. I just kind of threw a few images together, and here we go. So you'd see them sort of like this. And once you beat the first gym leader, you would be able to see the next one. They're not going to be appearing frequent. You have to be looking around for them. You're not going to get alerts. The only way you'd be able to know is if other people told you, and they would have to have beaten the first, second, third gym leader to even see the next progress like you. And then finally, once you've beaten all of these gym leaders and collected all of your badges, you would have the opportunity to receive a pass to go fight Elite Four. Now, I don't know if you'd get a pass for the Elite Four or it would be for the champion. I think the champion is more suitable. The Elite Fours are just going to be extremely rare, happening at random. And that would be that. It would be extremely hard. Let's say it's going to be equivalent to a Tier 4, Tier 5 raid. And you're probably wondering, well, how would that even work? You would actually have to back out and then heal. And it would give you a lot more time than your typical raid. So this is just a brainstorm, okay? This is just ideas throwing out there. And then finally, once you've beaten the Elite Four, then that's where I think the EX Pass or some sort of special invite will be sent to you for a specific gym in time. And all of the other people who have reached that point, just like you, within that time frame, would actually get a pass as well. And you would all have to battle it out. Now, all of this would be implemented when PvP was introduced. So it would be a fun way to have a battle system other than just, you know, the PvP head-to-head, you know, randomness. If you had some sort of order to it, some sort of invite system like that, I think that'd be a great new way to bring battles to Pokemon Go. So let's think about this for a minute. Most of these mobile apps have multiplayer. You can play with other people, and that's what makes them so fun. A lot of them, right? There's no excuse that this shouldn't either. We can do raids with each other. You know, soon we're going to be able to do PvP. But I think that this will make a great addition to the game because they have everything in place. If you think about it, the time frames, kind of like the raids. So everybody would have to, or the EX raids for Mewtwo, everybody would have to finish their fighting all of the gym leaders and then the Elite Four. And then if they do it within that time frame, then they'll be able to move on to the tournament. Now, I think the time frame for completing all that would be a little bit larger than the Mewtwo window, considering what you have to do. But it would be worth it. The prize would be something like, I don't know, 20, 50 raid passes and Poke coins and some other items, right? Now, if you're thinking, well, that's kind of a little generous of Niantic to just hand that out. Yeah, that's true. There would have to be some sort of pay-in for the raids. So maybe you wouldn't get a free pass, or you wouldn't even be able to get a pass. You just have to pay Poke coins to enter in for each gym leader. Because then that way there would be more incentive for you to try to get your kind of earnings back plus some for winning. Also, Niantic is earning money. I'm not trying to say they're greedy, but it's just kind of the way business works, all right? If you're an adult, you understand that. They're not going to just have tournaments and hand out free things. That's not the way the world works. All right, so now that I think of it, kind of brainstorming here on the video, it's sounds solid to me. And then what will happen after all the people who've completed everything and did what they need to do are finished? Say they beat all of the 8 gym leaders and then the Elite Four. Which gym? Where would they even meet up? Yes, so you would receive that pass, and there's going to be a new kind of gym that will be empty and inactive all the time, only active when you receive your pass in the time frame that is open, kind of like a Mewtwo raid. There'll be a bigger time window for these tournaments, though, because an hour, 45 minutes is not cutting it. I'm talking about 4 or 5 hours, so you can coordinate, or even maybe even longer, so you can coordinate, because not everybody's going to be ready. And to miss this would be really bad. It's not going to be like a Mewtwo, like, ah, well, we can try again, and maybe we might be able to get a pass. Wasn't able to get to the Mewtwo this time. But these ones are going to have much longer time frames. You have tried so much to get to this point, so just missing it would be complete devastating, right? So maybe like a whole day. That sounds about right. Anyways, so when you do receive your pass, you show up there, this empty gym stadium, new type of thing that they would add, would have streamers and fireworks going off and look really cool within Pokemon Go. Not in real life, no fireworks in real life, just in the game. All right, so then all the trainers are there. Who are you supposed to battle first? Well, on your ticket, it'll actually assign you. Or maybe once you get there, you put in some sort of code that you get through your pass that they send you, kind of like the EX Mewtwo passes. So you go there and then you enter it, or however it works, and then it'll say once everybody's signed in or something of the liking. I'm not too sure, because what if you sign in and the person you need to battle is like, oh, I'm not going to be able to make it for another 3 hours, sorry, come back. Then maybe you can just battle whoever's there. It'll just say battle one of the contestants, right? And as simple as that. And if you never show up, it'll just kind of exclude you out. And, you know, that's that. And at this point, it's not going to be like, he's level 40 and I'm only level 35. No, if you were able to make it this far, it's going to be just the way it is. You better get to level 38, because this is, at this point, it's going to be for the people who are strong, who are high level. And if you're like, well, that's not fair for us. Well, kind of it is. I mean, that's just the way it works, you know. You become a strong Pokemon master and you do Pokemon master things. You know, once you're a low level, you work your way up and then you become stronger and you're able to do it. Because first of all, you're going to have to get through the gym leaders. That's the trial right there. The real trial is going to be through the Elite Four. So that's what's going to weed out the other people, to make sure you're actually suitable for this tournament, because it's just going to be a standard. Once you have done these things and you've talked to your friend, he's like, yeah, man, I beat the Elite Four Lance, and he tells you how it went, and you just counter it with a specific team. It's going to be like fighting a Donphin raid, and somebody's like, yeah, I just fought Donphin. It had a counter and play rough, so look out for that. It'll be kind of like that. And these raid, or sorry, these Elite Fours, their Pokemon can will have random moves every time a trainer goes in, or it could be the same, kind of like the raid bosses, okay? So think about it like that. If you're not able to make it through the trials, then you simply are just not going to be able to get into the final league. And if that sounds a little harsh, you know, I don't know what to tell you. What should it be? Should it be easy? Should the champion have an easy way through all the way to the top and be proud of making it there with having to not really try that hard? I think not. It should be something that you earned. So there you go, trainers. Just a little, you know, fun conversation about gym leaders, Elite Four, and tournaments in Pokemon Go. I'll catch you all next time. Take care.